So with that, we come to our final speaker, which is Benoit Blanc. And Benoit is going to talk about QGIS, football, what else? And Benoit is a GIS developer at Auslandia since 2020. He's mainly working on the QGIS web client, as well as some other QGIS plugins. Auslandia is a French company providing services in open source GIS, particularly QGIS and PostGIS. So Benoit, I'd like to welcome you to the session, and we've shared your screen, and I will turn it over to you.
Yeah, thank you, Tom, for the introduction. I think I'm ready. So, here, okay. Hello, everyone. My name is Benoit Blanc. I've been working at Auslandia for 1 year. And today, I'm going to talk about a particular use case of QGIS, since we are going to see that we can use QGIS to visualize football data. And to do so, let me introduce you QSoccer. That is a QGIS plugin to display football football data in QGIS Canva. So maybe you are wondering where does this idea of using GIS to display football data come from. First, I have always been a football fan. And I am interested from time to time in match analysis and tacticals by reading some books and articles on the web. And during my studies in geomatics, I did some researches on the use of football data in GIS. And I found some results, some articles that speaks about using GIS softwares and others to show football data. I have also discovered that there was a lot of data used in to analyze football matches. Also on Twitter, there are a lot of data visualizations, and I realized that there are many, many different possibilities to represent what is happening during a match. So, I wanted to do my my own visualizations to do my first attempts to play with football data by using several languages, programming languages such as JavaScript and Python, and some libraries that I will talk about later. And when I started to work at Auslandia last year, I presented these visualizations to my colleagues. And they asked me, why don't you use QGIS to display your data? And so the idea of creating QSoccer was born. So concerning the Twitter data visualizations, you can find many of them with, for example, the hashtag maybe football analytics or something like that. And I will show you some examples here. As I am not an expert in football analytics, I'm trying to do my best to explain some of these examples. So first, we have here a shot map from a player that represents shots taken by this player during several seasons. By differentiating left-footed shots in blue and right-footed shots in red, and the size of the circles represent expected goal value. Here is another shot map made by StatsBomb. It is a shot map for an entire team. And here there are different types of shots. We have a free kick, penalty, headed header shots, foot shots, and these type of shots are represented with different shapes. And here in this example, the expected goal value is represented by the color of each point. The aim of this visualization is to show the location and the number of touches done by a player for a season. and to show how and where this player is the most influential during a match. And for this example, the field is divided into hexagons. Here we have three football fields where you can see attacking contribution for a player. So we can see passes and shots attempted by this player with different ways to represent them if it is a key pass, an assist, or a goal. Here is a pitch control where positions of each player are represented, and the field is colored in blue or red depending on the nearest player at each point. Oops, sorry. And you can see here another way to represent pitch control with Voronoi, a kind of Voronoi polygons. And this example could be done with QGIS. Here is a simple visualization to show all the pressure events done by a player. Nothing special here. This one represents all the passes made during a competition. It also takes into account the Z dimension with the height of the passes. And this example has been done with observable HQ platform, and you could find the notebook by following this link. To finish this passing network, to summarize all the interactions, all the passes made between the players of a team during a match, and you can see that each point represents the average position of each player for the match, and the size and color of each point represent the number of passes. And this one is my first visualization, so it was my first attempt to play with football data, so informations are missing here, but we will see that I did the same thing by using QGIS later. So all of these data visualizations have been done using different programming languages, libraries, and tools such as JavaScript, Python, R, D3 library, Matplotlib, Observable HQ, and others. To do these visualizations, we need data, and in football, there are two types of data. You have event data, which represents all the interactions between the players and the ball, such as passes, tackles, shots, pressure events, and others. And you have another type of data, which is tracking data, and it represents players and ball positions during the whole match. For each of these records in event or tracking data, you can find X and Y coordinates. So we can say that football is spatial, and we could use GIS to display data. And here are some data providers like StatsBomb, OptaSports, Metrical Sports, Skill Corner, Wisecout, and there are others that collect event data, tracking data, or both of them. And you can see by following these links, data made available by these providers to allow some guys like me to play with football data and create your own way to analyze a match or create your own visualization. To start playing with football data, I used some open source libraries that make it easier to process the data, such as Clopy, which is a Python library to load, filter, transform tracking and event data from different providers. I also used MPL Soccer to display data on football charts using Matplotlib. It is also a Python library. And there are other libraries and tools that exist, and they are listed on pysport.org. You can find some libraries for soccer, but also for other sports like basketball, baseball, or others. And I also used some resources to learn football analytics with Python and R with the two websites, FC Python and FC Rstat. So we started to develop a QSoccer plugin. To do so, we used the QGIS plugin template, which helps you to create a QGIS plugin with good practices about tooling, code structuration, documentation, and test. And thanks to Julien Moura from Auslandia, who started the development of this tool. In the first time, we decided to focus only on the open data provided by StatsBomb, because it is the most complete data set that you can find in open data. And there are many, many matches available in this data set. And also, we decided to display data using MPL Soccer in a QGIS widget. As you can see, there is a result here. But this is not satisfying because we cannot easily change the symbology, the color of these arrows without modifying the source code. So it is not relevant for the end user. So here comes the second step. We decided to use QGIS main canvas to plot our events. To do so, we have created a vector layer as a geo package to represent the field, the soccer pitch, with polygons, lines, and points. And we did some symbology to make it nicer. Then we have a widget to choose competition, match, team, and player. So data is downloaded from StatsBomb dataset, and you can choose then to plot passes, shots, and heat map. So now you can finally display your data, passes, or for now there are only passes and shots available. And if you choose to display passes from a player, a temporary layer is created in your QGIS project with the name of the competition and the match, and the name of the player and the type of actions he did in this match. Also, there is a symbology, a default symbology, which is applied on each of these layers depending on the attributes that you have in your dataset. For example, there is a specific symbology for color for the goals, another one for the completed pass, and so on. And the benefit of using QGIS here is that end user can directly change symbology if the default one doesn't fit to him, and no need to modify the source code. Here is a video where you can see the use of the plugin. So first, we have a demo project that is opened in QGIS with some stadiums that are displayed on the map. These stadiums have been stored in a database. Then in the widget, you can choose a competition from the StatsBomb dataset. You can see that there are many competitions available, and you can choose a match from this competition. Then you can choose between the home team and the away team, and you have the list of the players which have played in this match. So you can select one and choose to display his passes or his shots. So when you choose to display passes or shots, the plugin zooms automatically to the soccer pitch to see the passes or shots. And you have the symbology by default, which is applied. and you can see some attributes such as the receiver of the pass, the body part that has been used to do the pass, and some other attributes. And the same thing for the shot, like the expected goal value, if it is a goal or not, and others. To go further, we can display all the passes done by a whole team by selecting player by player and plot all the passes for each player in your QGIS project. Then you can use QGIS layout to create some visualizations. So here is an example, but you can see that there are a lot of information. So we could summarize it by generating a pass network like the ones I showed you at the beginning of this presentation. And I will only use QGIS to do this. So to do this this pass network, I used processing tools in QGIS. Here are some of them. It is not in order and it is not exhaustive. But for example, I used mean coordinates to get the average position for each player. To get the number of passes for each player, I used count points in a polygon to count the passes in the soccer pitch. And I used the dissolve merge vector layers. I used also a graphic modeler and a geometry generator to create a symbology and to create curve lines to draw the lines between two players. As a reminder, here is my first attempt to play with football data using D3 library. And here is the result I have by using QGIS and all of its tools. So it is not a perfect result yet, but it is still better than this one. And once again, I can easily do some changes as I am in QGIS if the result doesn't suit to me, I can easily change the symbology or the QGIS layout. And now here are some ideas of features to improve QSoccer plugin. We have already created a database to store some stadiums in Europe, but we could also store teams, players, and events to avoid downloading CSV file and JSON files from data providers and use only a database. As I showed you before, you can use QGIS processing tools to analyze football matches in your own way. So it could be nice to implement all the processings I do before to automatically generate pass networks. We could include other data providers than StatsBomb. We could also use other type of events because for now there are only shots and passes available. So we could add pressure, tackles, and overs. We could include tracking events from Metrica Sports provider, for example. And also we could play with time manager in QGIS to view the match frame by frame with event and tracking data. So I tried to do this with Time Manager, but I don't have a satisfying result yet. Also, here is the link of a repository, so you can report issues, and merge requests are welcomed if you want to contribute to this project. And you can send us your idea to improve this plugin. To conclude, it is a fun project that we started here, and I'm really happy to talk about it with you today. We used what we call open source time at Auslandia and some personal time to create this plugin. And it is a great opportunity for me to discover some QGIS features I didn't know yet, such as a graphic modeler, time manager, or a geometry generator. And it helps me to improve my skills to develop a QGIS plugin as I am still a beginner to QGIS plugin development. So it is all a benefit for me to work on this project. And thank you for listening. You can find the presentation here if you want to go to the links I have put in it. I can paste it in the chat.
Excellent. Thank you, Benoit, for the interesting presentation. I can say that I've seen it all now. Using QGIS to analyze soccer is something else. And this is a really interesting piece of work. We have one question from the audience. What is the effort to extend the plugin to other sports?
First, you have to be interested in other sports, like for example basketball or others. I think that you just have to create the right vector layer to represent your field. So the basketball pitch, for example, or tennis, or anything else. And just play with the data. I didn't mention it during the presentation, but there was a presentation about basketball in QGIS that has been done by Benur Pinter for the QGIS Open Day in June. So I can just paste the link in the chat if you want to see this nice presentation. Casketball, yes, I see it in the chat. Thank you, Julien. So it depends on the spot. Mm-hmm.
When will it put? So excellent project. When will it push to Plugin Planet?
I don't understand the question. To Plugin Planet? I don't know.
Is it available on like the? I don't know whether they're talking about the QGIS plugin repository.
It is not an official plugin yet. You have to go you have to check out the documentation, and you have a procedure to install it and play with it. Maybe I can find it here. Okay. So it is not. It is not an official QGIS plugin yet.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned in your presentation open source time. What is open source time?
What we call open source time. It's a time that we have in Auslandia company where we can contribute to open source projects and create new ones. So We use a part of this time to create this plugin thanks to Auslandia and with some other colleagues that are in the chat, Raphael and Julien. And also there is a lot of personal time because you have to be interested in football analytics and other stuff to create this plugin.
Next question. Did you implement the plugin out of passion, or is it a paid project, or a bit of both?
It is a passion. Football is a passion for me. And it is not a paid project. We just used open source time for now. But if someone wants to fund some features, it would be a pleasure to work with you.
How do you, or how does StatsBomb deal with teams switching sides at halftime, for example, to calculate a player's mean position?
I think that StatsBomb or other providers collect the each event with a range of coordinates. I think the StatsBomb coordinates are from 0 to 120 in the length of the field, I don't know how they deal with switching sides. I don't know, but I think they just take a kind of ratio of the field and they report it when they collect the data. Maybe if you go to the StatsBomb documentation of Open Data, it is written.
Let's comment. Assuming a fan of Football Manager, great use of open source time. I've always wondered whether it was possible to do this in QGIS. Certainly, you've made this a reality. So, congrats again. Next question: is StatsBomb data through an open license?
There are a part of data that has been made available by StatsBomb, but I don't know the license that is used for this open data. No, I don't know.
Next question: what technologies are used to collect this sort of data?
Some type of data are collected manually by a lot of people that are working during a football match, but you have also technologies that acquire the data automatically with video. I don't know how to say that with video recognition, maybe. I don't know the right term. And you have also GPS tracking for the tracking data. But I think that it is forbidden during the football match, during the competitions.
And finally, can it analyze A-League data?
I think A-League data is in Australia, I guess. And I don't know if there is some data available. Maybe you can check on Twitter. It is my main source to know about football analytics, and maybe you can check there if there are some guys interested in A-League and data from this championship.
Excellent. Great round of questions and very interesting and fun presentation, Benoit. So I thank you. I thank you for that. And I also expect at our next, Phosphor G face-to-face event, we will have a soccer match between all the different parts of the community and Phosphor G, and we can extend this plug-in to analyze our movements during that soccer game or football game. Yeah. Doesn't matter. So thank you very much.
It will be a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you. Excellent. So with that, I'd like to thank Benoit. And thank all of you, thank all of the speakers, and thank all of the audience for today's session. I think we had a great round of very fun and interesting talks from a number of diverse topics. So thank you for that. I would also like to thank Diego Morera for helping with the support around the audio and video. And with that, I will leave that to you. Enjoy the rest of the conference. Stay safe and have a good day. Thank you.